Alrighty then, let's get this first stream going. Not too bad. I had work this morning, but I actually managed to get to bed early last night, and so I was quite well rested. And I literally just woke up a map, drank some coffee, and I feel quite good. How about you? Good, good. You doing any homework then, or literally just... Oh, fair enough. What class have you got? Can't pick my nose on stream. Ah, fair enough. Yeah, just to warn everyone, today's probably going to be a bit of a short stream. Oh, fair enough. Is that like English literature or what? Okay, campaign mode. I wonder if that is that pronounced Jomar Through failure, do we tend to learn the most valuable of lessons, provided we survive? Oh, come on. Okay, slug market, where you can trade your forage good for things of greater value. Interact, browse the wares. Odd creature. Okay, what voice to give the odd creature? Hey guys! Yep, that works. Hey guys! Hey, how's it going? Mr. Greentail? Been a while and all that? Hey Ron, it's going. Ron, here's a travelling sales creature and proprietor of the Downside Slug Market. Say, how come you've set up shop all the way out here? Isn't this a little out of the way? Oh well, let's just say you guys, you ain't my only customers. You see, Dad and I, we know this business pretty good. We've been around the block and so... As Ron keeps blathering, Ruki signals you in a furtive way. Don't know why that's in Ruki's voice, but okay. Here's the deal, sister. Got an informant says there's something around here connected to the rights, this rights business. See if you can spot it. Should be able to pawn off some of our stuff to make the trade. And don't even worry about Falcon Ron. That's the coolest name ever. So, anyways, you guys got something for me or what? That plain parcel you got there. I could take it off your paws if you want. Plain parcel. This can be trade item. Value 30. This can be sold at the slug market. Certain types of luxury goods somehow find their way down to the downside. Oh, fair. So, is that like, That sounds a bit like English literature. I don't know, maybe they merged the two, sort of the different disciplines a bit. Drag plain partial to Ron's stash. Fair enough. Confirm transaction. Fair enough. Hey, you know, I'll take it, Mr. Greentail. Though you drive a pretty hard bargain. Now you're gonna take something off my hands here or what? Drag moon crest to your stash. Rank 10 talisman. Effect. After being banished by an adversary, the bearer has a chance to return immediately. 30%. trinket resembling the intricate sigil of the Nightwings. It shines with a faint light. That's a one-of-a-kind thing you just got there, you know? And you got yourself a real good deal for me as well, so thanks. Wait, if we got the good deal, why are you thanking us? Switch to the roster to look at the talisman. Apparently any one of us bozos can get a little edge out of the thing. During the rites, I mean. Just a question of who gets to try it out. Each of your fellow exiles may have a talisman equipped. Talisman. Items imbued with various enchantments. Exiles may equip one at a time. A talisman's true power lies in the faith of its holder. That's a talisman equipped then. Anyways, Dad over here. His feet, you know. We've been having some trouble with his feet. Getting real something or other from all the hoofing around, and so you see. Ruki indicates that to you that now would be a good time to depart. Don't have the money to buy anything else. See you, Mr. Greentail. And your friend there, too. I like her. Seems real nice, you know.
Ah.
Okay, let's just take a look around the wagon. When that minstrel actually do something. Okay, let's play this game. As you complete preparations for the rites to commence, you notice Chai approaching. So Chai is a little, I guess she's sort of albino girl who just sort of showed up earlier. You notice too that she's wearing your companion's raiment. We can go home. Chai, I thought I made it myself quite clear that you were not to touch those robes. Sorry, Miss Jodriel. I just thought maybe you were being funny at the time. Unbelievable. Hey, something's happening in the sky. I think we're up. Oh, guess I'm going to have to play with her instead of the... What's that guy's name again? It's been a couple of days since I played it, so. During the rites, avoid the auras of your adversaries and banish them with your own. You lose your aura when you grasp the orb.
Reader, what brings you to the spring of Jomia?
How's the audio, by the way?
It must have been the stars.
I did notice that the game was a bit quiet last stream.
Not the expected three? The rules of the rites were not created for you to besmirch. Prepare now to confront the fate. They still honor the traditions of the scribes, and surely have been longing for this chance. But first, you have a choice to make.
Okay, hang on. Let's try that. Is that better? How good. The sky burns bright once more as your next adversaries and the riots approach. Their apparent leader is a bent old cur who regards you with a formal bow.
Yes.
At his side is an intense young man. Dalbert.
I hail you, exiles of the Nightwings, and I am grateful that you chose to grace us with your presence once again. I am Dalbert Oldheart, and this is my son, Alma.
Dalbert Oldheart. He is an honourable old cur bent on upholding the sacred traditions of the rites with his son. So the curs are basically a dog-like race. Alma Oldheart. He is the dutiful foster son, well, that explains it, of Dalbert Oldheart, and is very protective of him above all else.
Not tan them, father.
We do not need to greet them, father.
Rare Rimnayas.
We shall face you on the fields this night, and may the victor's pyre burn eternal. But first, we offer you a token of good faith, and a show of appreciation that the Nightwings have returned. Dalbert approaches you with something in his paw. You sense his motives are sincere as he hands to you a small talisman. You received a Tailwind Crest from Dalbert. Effect grants the bearer +2 quickness. A forged metal brooch, cool to the touch, depicting some triumph of the Sedum Union. Thank him and begin. That cur was very kind, and his son, he was so caring, wasn't he?
Sheila!
When can we start? I want to help you beat them. Oh, I love this kid.
We need the three of us, exactly, to conduct a ride. But we've got four now, besides the reader. This ought to be her call. If someone has to stand aside this time, I volunteer.
Catiro.
No volunteering, chum. It ought to be the reader's call, remember? Very well, reader. Who shall it be? Henceforth, you shall choose three exiles to conduct each rite. Prepare to make your choice.
Now, let us begin.
Okay, so... gonna choose her because I can't even tell us...
Jodariel!
As you will. Okay, I'm gonna choose Rookie because God, he's gonna be quick with this talisman.
Rookie!
Don't have to tell me twice, sister.
And I wanna see what the new kid can do.
Che!
Oh, me? Thank you. Thank you for believing in me, because I think the scribes do too.
The choice is cast.
Hey, I'll have other chances. I think you did the right thing.
Dalbert. Nightwings, I trust that you are well prepared for these old eyes, yet see that the rite shall be commencing momentarily. Are you quite ready too, my son?
Esprage, father.
I hope so too, father. Here, now let me show you.
Begin. The orb bathes first within the Nightwing's flame. Begone! Banishment for all! Glorious! Verily.
The fourth, my son.
Yeah, I'll try and give her a bit more menacing voice. Maybe something like... Wait, is Alma the... Wait, is Alma again? The son.
The fourth, my son. The waters of Dura Menemane brings blessings onto us this eve. Perhaps our chance has come at last.
No mare visu.
We need more than blessings to prevail against them, Father. Please keep fighting.
A boon come from the stars themselves. But shall it be enough for Dalbert and his faithful son? Zap. Ruki, douse to the adversary's flames. Shame. Opportunity.
Oops.
Another banishment. How very sad for the fate. Onward thus to greater glory.
It's all soon.
Dalbert banished. Remains engulfed within the aura. The orb, take it. And it is dark. The Nightwings prevail. With a glorious performance, I must say. Perhaps you shan't be quite so fortunate next time.
Belafontaine.
Bruce? It seems we have prevailed.
Parecitamo. Yes, I mean, I guess.
Sinodonashe.
You know, I think I'm going to give Chai sort of a grudge ghost type voice.
I wonder what will happen to the Fates. They seem so nice, don't they? Exiles of the Nightwings, the Dawn is yours, and you may earn your freedom. But Father, the Dawn might have been ours. We failed. I have failed you. Nonsense. We are the Fate. We do what is ordained, nothing less.
The Fate, an honourable... Oh, that's them. An honourable triumvirate, determined to uphold the traditions of the rites, led by the Cur, Dalbert Oldheart, of the Helfer's adopted son, the savage Alma the Helpless.
Now let us go, my son, for I am wary once again.
There is much to learn from this experience. It would seem the exiled Jodariel has a knack for these affairs.
Focus, training, prayeress. The practice of awkward survival on the blood border. These rites make some advance of us.
seems the exiled rookie opened up his eyes a bit.
See, that's old chums. Old rookie Green Tail's got some bison in him yet. Okay, what do we have here? Jump, double jump. That's nice.
Blessing from jump. The Alpha Chief himself. Until the stars align.
Hello. Excuse me. I mean, would you excuse me for a moment, did you think?
Setame frunta.
You. You're one of them. What do you want? Father needs me.
Sala Haloshianus.
Like if Sokka and Prince Zuko were the same character. Oh, sorry. I think I forgot what I was going to say. I'm so embarrassed, I...
Lurigas and Nirugas.
What's the matter with you? Is it against the rights for us to even speak like this?
Sir Tabas Talia?
I did not know that. I don't think. No one said anything like that to me, but then... All this is very new to me, and so I thought maybe.
Cruce tarikta.
You cannot be serious.
Shela.
Yeah, I mean, I like to laugh. I like to laugh a lot. And you? How about you?
Halibrale krandas.
This is a Nightwing's trick. Father told me not to speak with any of you. But I just.
Ah.
I have to go.
Pistalia.
Wait, Arma. Wait. I think that was your name. Was that even your name? Yeah, I think they have different portraits for when they're wearing the masks, when they're holding the masks. Don't know if I've seen any sprites where they're not actually even holding them, but anyway. Wait! You may switch to a different difficulty setting at any time in the options menu. Did something. As you return to the wagon after prevailing over the fades, you notice Joderiel tense up and frown.
McGurl.
Where does he go?
Is that Pam?
Who? Wait, the sleeping guy?
Some mirror.
The minstrel. He's gone. You see, it's true. There's no trace of the lone minstrel who'd been lying still in the corner of the wagon all this time. Join the others in search for him outside. Your fellow exiles have revealed nothing to you of the lone minstrel or how they found him, though you sense their concern as they scour the vicinity for him. Don't worry about the minstrel, my friend. You worry about the stars. Wherever they guide us, we're going. You gaze up at the stars once more. The Midnight Star. Hat up. The Midnight Star burns bright over the standing stones at the edge of the flagging hands. Ooh, that's pretty metal.
Simdare.
Everyone, we're headed back east, all the way across the valley. Towards the Khan of Hub, then. Khan of Hub. According to the stars, the next rite shall commence here. The accursed imp here failed the mighty bone titan, Shaq Six-Hawk Shoulders.
Krikari.
That's right, we'll have to risk it.
Krikari.
What if that minstrel guy doesn't turn up by then?
Birta.
We shall find him, on this night or another. They continue here searching for some time. However, the minstrel is nowhere to be found. Chai's scribe catcher. The bundle of sticks Chai insisted on hanging in the rafters. She believes it brings good fortune. Status, out for a walk. I love that everyone has their own sort of thing that tells you who's doing what and where. Okay, Hedwyn has something on his mind. After having bested Fate in a decisive victory last night, you find Hedwyn off on his own. You sense he wants to talk about your decision to exclude him from conducting the rites.
I guess we'll have some tough choices to make before all this is over, my friend. Just been thinking about that. I'm glad you let the others go instead of me during the rites. I mean that, all the more since we succeeded. I don't know what's more intense, participating in the rite, or just watching from the sidelines. Anyway, thank you for checking in. I'm off to go make sure we're ready to move.
He departs to check on things outside. He says that he has no misgivings about what transpired, and is more concerned at present about the missing minstrel. Savage. Simple folk ostracized for their deficiencies or differences even prior to their sentencing. Also called the Moon Touch, they prove overly resistant to the principles of lawful society. The Faithful Drifter. She is a young vagabond girl with an odd manner and an unshakable sense of curiosity. Fraser Rory in a straight line, plants her feet, then jumps to evade. Gains a sudden burst of speed after a moment. Race, savage, past, moon-touched. The Commonwealth never did know how to handle those who did not fit neatly into its mould. It is said those born under a wild moon opt to leave a charmed and troubled life. Observations. She appears to be a vagabond who has wandered the downside for some time and has somehow managed to get by. Her simple and sincere demeanour suggests she was likely shunned in the Commonwealth and would have been considered a savage by the standards there. She seems unusually interested in the legends of the Eight Scribes. Yeah, she's just a mythology nerd then. Okay, let's continue then. There's still no signs of the lonely minstrel. Although Jodiel tracks potential signs of movement east, the same way you're headed, you considered where to search for him. Blue Hive, the north reach across the Jomo Valley passes the main swoops. Didn't mean to do that. Oh well. Oh, hey, Freud. I thought you'd gone to class. As you travel through the dry flats of Glue Hive, the lifeless carapace of Iamphlanthris still leans over the western edge of the valley. Hedwyn seems more ill at ease than usual. There's no sign of the missing minstrel.
Sorry about this, Jody. I had a hunch he must have come this way.
Oh, fair enough. Everyone's got to go. Would that our hunches could be more dependable, but do not fear, we shall find him yet.
Sounds like a hunch to me.
More of a promise. You pick up bits and pieces of the minstrel's significance to your fellow exiles. He was there when they first discovered the Black Wagon, but they refused to say much more for now. stop the wagon.
Okay, Sam.
What? How come?
Woman at all.
Because of her.
Verona.
They're coming. They're coming for us. We have to be ready. We have to.
Convare cantus.
Does she mean what she thinks I... Does she mean what I think she means?
I believe so. Your fellow exiles scramble to prepare the wagon for whatever is out there. Once you help them settle in, perhaps you could learn more of their source of concern. Righty. They are coming for us. They fear the scribe. Wait, they fear the scribes. They fear the scribes. I know they do. What's she talking about? What's going on? Howlers, lots of them. Then what are we going to do? They fear the scribes.
Fortune.
Calm yourself, Chai. We shall give you reason to fear us as well.
We'll use the raiments and the books.
Acceptable.
Indeed, one of us can draw them out under the reader's watch. It shall be just like one of our rites. Oh, that's convenient. You don't need to make any vehicle noise. Edwin turns to you. Seems we need your help in this, my friend. We just need a volunteer to go with you. I'll do it, miss. Please, you have to let me. And the scribes, they'll protect me. I know they will. Jadriel exchanges looks with Hedwin. Each of them nods at you, as if to signal their approval. Chai intends to help fend off the howlers. Prepare for them. Is it Earth now at last? It is, I think it is. Oh, those poor and wretched beasts.
Huh?
Just then, Chara spots something creeping like towards her.
Huh? What?
Ferocious creature. Well, that would have been very useful before. Apparently, if you release it with perfect timing, it's sort of a power cast, which is actually how range attacks works in Bastion, so more for me. The howling subsides as your fellow exiles scramble to check on Chai. Find her in one piece, along with an unfamiliar little face. Oh my god, look at that. Drive in. Isn't he the best? Isn't he the best? Can we keep him? Yep, move over Squirts. The new super giant mascot. You sense a depth of experience in this creature, at least judging by driving standards. In fact, you feel a connection to him. If you concentrate, perhaps you can derive some meaning from his calls and screeches. The drive imp seems both excited and frustrated by something. Interact to try and understand him. Sense some passion in the drive imp's screeches. He seems welcoming of this. This drive imp seems to have a history of your black wagon. You're beginning to understand him. The drive imp recognizes you as the new reader of the Nightwings. He is pleased to meet you. You can now understand this unusual drive imp. The drive imp seems satisfied at having gotten through to you. And you explain to your companions what little you've learned of them so far. No one argues against letting the creature come along. Inside the wagon, the other drive imps stare at him with something like reverence. I guess he's an essential employee. Oh, good. It's always good to learn new languages, eh? Drive imp joined you. He seems to know his way around. So is he going to turn out to be the minstrel in cursed form or something? He reminds me of Gizmo. Drive imp. He seems to have something on his mind. You can see the little imp has made himself at home. He rushes right up to you. God, he's so cute. Your new imp companion seems to be very pleased to be in the wagon. He indicates he was able to find you thanks to the swarm of howlers. He has no love of howlers, and they know not to mess with him either. He plans to set up a nest that should ward off any further trouble from them. He looks forward to the road ahead with everyone and believes it shall be worth it. He seems to be saying he is happy to be back where he belongs, and he urges you to keep going. He bounds off towards his brethren, settled in the wagon's rafters. Well then. Okay, onward then. Yeah, I'm probably going to just be streaming for another quarter of an hour or so. Like I said, I'm only going to do a quick stream today. Lixand, an arid seventh pass towards the ominous Cairn of Hurub. Your new imp friend seems insistent that you take this path bearing east. Let's agree with the imp then. Hedwyn orders the wagon to halt somewhere in the dry flats of Yomir Valley.
There's someone on the road. Be careful, everyone.
The figure watching the black wagon from afar approaches. Arms spread wide, although a hat and cloak conceal the figure's features. Then the imp rushes out to whomever it is. The imp is very riled up at the sight of whoever it is approaching, although in an almost joyous way. Yeah, we all have friends like that. The Lone Minstrel. Tizzle, it is good to see you, and you found the others, even faster than expected. Tizzo, he is a venerable driver imp who seems to know the ins and outs of the Nightwing's black wagon. Yeah. Guess this is the minstrel then. Wonder what he was doing. The imp called Tizzo appears very pleased. The lone minstrel turns towards the rest of you.
Bon dia, man.
Oh no, not at all, Froy. I absolutely prefer people talking more. It's getting a bit dark in here, isn't it? That's better. I mean, the more you talk, the more Twitch acknowledges my channel's having people watching it, so that's good. Also, it makes me feel less like I'm just talking to no one, which probably is a sign of madness. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm in the DSM-5 in several places, but... anyway. What voice to give this guy? Hello. We have not met, but I know who you are, or who you must be. I returned as promptly as I could. Have you walked with the scribes themselves? Because I think maybe you have.
Hello indeed. You had us worried there when you took off.
I should knock him back into his slumber. I did not aim to cause you such concern. As soon as I awakened, I had to notify my client that the Nightwings had returned. Your client?
Son Felicet.
Aye, my client. Sandalwood. Yes, I'll give him a Welsh accent. Aye, my client. Sandalwood. He is your point of contact, as I understand. He did not find his wagon by mistake. Boyo.
So what now?
You continue down the path. This way, Mir. When we meet my client, he shall explain. For now, you have a job to do. I assure you that I shall not interfere. But I mean to accompany you. Would that be all right? Hedwyn and the others exchange looks.
Welcome back, minstrel. You got a name?
Simdase.
I'm sometimes called Tarik. It is a pleasure to meet you, Nightwings. Tarik, the lone minstrel. He appears to be a travelling musician, yet seems to be connected to the rites. The lone minstrel, return to the black wagon with your fellow exiles. Third. The Cairn of Hurub is a foreboding sight. It is here that the next rite is soon to commence.
Ligaratus?
Reader, if you have a moment, once we're settled on these grounds, I wish to speak to you in the wagon at your leisure. Ooh, I can buy stuff. Oh, hey guys. Fancy running into you this side of the sand. So what can I do you for?
Yeah.
Ron, how do you make all this way ahead of us? Now, come on now, Mr. Greentail. Can't give away all my business secrets, am I right? I can do, though, saying as you've been such a good customer and all. It's provide you a little sample of something if you like. Here, check this out. Seeing as you bought that moon crest finger from me last time, well, I'm just thinking you could use this, and I got more if you want. You received a pinch of stardust. It does seem useful. Consumable item. Raises the rank of certain talismans plus one. Drag to your talisman to enhance it. Usable wands. A shimmering substance with mystical properties, said to come from the heavens themselves. Thank Ron for the sample. Interact with Ron to quiet him down. He is a travelling sales creature and a proprietor of the downside slug market. Amazing. Lucrative contract. Rank 10 talisman. Effect. After banishing an adversary, the bearer gains plus 1 goals, up to this many times per right. 10. An order is an order for some foolhardy wanderer to seek out some well-imagined fortune in the downside. Ashen Coal. Effect. At the start of the right, the bearer's pyre automatically gains plus 7. A brittle clump of ash from a ritual pyre, still faintly warms the touch somehow. Kerfang. When plunging into the adversary's pyre, the bearer deals bonus damage, plus 2. An old tooth from a cur who no longer needs it. Although its owner is gone, her fiery spirit lives. Yeah. I love his, demeanor. And I love that you can shut him up. All day. I mean, come on, that is a customer service smile if I've ever seen one. Yeah, I think he's also a. Well, I think he's supposed to be a snail, but he was referring to him as his dad earlier. So, I guess he's his dad. Unless you mean this. Which I also think so. But maybe it's his little brother or something, I don't know. Customer service smile off. Customer service smile on. Smile off. Smile on. Smile off. Smile on. Smile on. Freezy diamond. Anyway. Lunar glass. While carrying the orb, the bearer moves faster than usual, plus 10%. A light and reflective bit of something fallen from the stars. It seems lighter still at night. So I'll take some of this. I know you're gonna like that stuff, guys. It's pretty. Whoa! Know what I mean? And if you want some more, now I just know the individual. Just the individual and his dad, you can get it. Catch my meaning, yeah? Just stop on by some other time. Okay. Extra 7 to the pyre. Any of these. More gold would be nice.
Yeah. Bye, Tyson. Molly, bye, Tyson. Molly, simple, see me tell your friends.
Tell your friends about us, because I already told mine. All the dialogue in this is gold. The Lone Minstrel. He seems to have something on his mind. The Lone Minstrel seems to have situated himself in the wagon. He is very still, not unlike when he was sleeping.
Oh dear, Alligatus.
Reader, I shall keep this brief. As you surely have a right, you must conduct. You have read something of the Book of Rites, which means that you may know something of my nature. On the contrary, you know not he means, as he soon senses this. Forgive me, for I spoke too soon. Suffice it, I have served the Nightwings for a long time. Conduct the rites with glory, and you shall achieve what you seek. The lone minstrel nods farewell to you and steps away. Oh, that was cryptic. White Lute, the lone minstrel Tarek's musical instrument, with which he chronicles great deeds through song. The lone minstrel and his white lute chronicle the journey of the Nightwings through song. Using it, you may hear glimpses of your past experiences across the downside. Which piece of music do you wish to hear? Have I got an achievement for that? Book of Rites. The Rope Caller. I knew it was a fool's errand, but my liege, he would not listen. He instead insisted to pursue a certain treasure, a celestial orb, freshly fallen from the heavens in the reach of the downside. He would be a living legend if only he could grasp it, whispered in his ear that Kylimer Rope Caller, his elder and most trusted aide. Would that I slew the man myself. His was a simple yet brilliant ruse. To draw the Emperor farther still from his responsibilities and towards his greed. Thus did the Emperor begin an expedition into the Forsaken Lands. He insisted that he go himself. Okay, let's equip those talismans then. Do I give him the contract or... Okay, I'm going to give this kid this because I want to get her back. I'll give him this just for the cash. Actually... because she's quite good at banishing enemies. Give him that. Enhance that. Because you can use it to get more goals. Yeah, this music, you're right, Freud, this music's amazing. So this is going to be a short stream, so I think I'll call things here. Thanks everyone for watching. I'll just find someone to raid. Yep, bye Froy. I hope everyone's been, I hope everyone's enjoyed watching, like I already said a moment ago. And obviously I'll be streaming again on Friday. Obviously I'll be playing this match we just got to the area for. Okay, Froy, I hope you have a good class. I'll just find someone to raid. Quite a few people I know are streaming right now. Yeah, I don't want to be streaming too late because I want to... Well, obviously it's still quite early in the day, but I've got a doctor's appointment tomorrow I can't really miss because with everything going on, it's going to be impossible to get another one. Anywho, let's see. We've got His Curseness or Andres Indrel. think I'll raid Andres, because he's only got one person watching right now. And raid in 3, 2, 1, and go. And raid in 3, 2, 1, and go. And raid in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, Brioche. Hello, raiders. What are you doing? Oh, shite. Oh, excellent. You managed to duke them just enough to not get the full prompt of, well, 2 armies worth of enemies? One? This is not the sort of music you would expect from battle time, is it? Currently on elegant. Give me something epic. There we go.